What's up, people? Just thought I'd toss up a quick video. Got a brew day going on and got some beer mail, and I'm not going to really video the brew day. I'll just tell you about it. I'm in about 20 minutes in to the mash, 60 minute mash of my first lager, and it's mashing away, and I got my sparge water heating up. So I've never brewed a lager, and probably be tying up my chest freezer at about 50 degrees for I don't know, a week or two, whatever it is. I have to go back and look at my notes, and then I'm going to lager in my beer fridge in there. So we'll see how that goes. I kind of looked at the Victory Prima Pils clone. I mentioned this before, none of my clones ever turn out to be clones. I think in the past I've cloned one beer that was spot on. But the Victory Prima Pils recipe was on Homebrew Talk. It was one, I don't know, I can't remember who put it up or who talked about it or where it came from. Maybe it was from Zymergy magazine. But I'm using like 10 pounds of German Pils, and some of the hops I didn't have, or actually I could have got them, but I wanted to get all the stuff from the same place to save shipping. So I've got like Saz, however you pronounce it, at 60 minutes, Tettnang at 30 minutes, Hallertal, is that the way you pronounce that? Middelfrua, I don't know how to pronounce that one either. That one's at 20 minutes, and Saz again at 10 minutes. So it's kind of a hoppy recipe for a Pilsner from what I've read. I'm not familiar with the style too much other than drinking it. Never really studied making it or anything. I've meant to study on brewing classic styles, but just haven't had the time. But it's like 1050, I think the recipe on Homebrew Talk was 1053, and with the grains I had and the boil volumes and everything, it was like 1051, and the IBUs were right at that, which is a little high for this Pilsner, but we'll see. For a Pilsner, I should say, from what I've read. So it was like 50 IBUs, somewhere around there. I don't remember. I can go in here and look. The yeast I chose was the American Lager yeast, 2035, I think, Y yeast. Let me run in here real quick and just see what the IBUs were on this. And I know it's dark in here, so sorry. Actually, it was 51 IBUs, so like a 51 IBUs, 51, 1051 starting gravity. So I'm hoping I'll go over my gravity a little bit, but we'll see. And that's 75% efficiency. Yep. So we'll see. See how it turns out. And the Y yeast 2035 is the American lager. And I kind of went back and forth on which lager yeast to use, but I just said to heck with it. It's going to be kind of a test batch anyway, so we'll see how it goes. Other than that, just chilling out. Oh, I got my... I've been meaning to do a video on my yeast, on making yeast starters and using Mr. Malty and yeastcalc.com, because I had to do a step starter for this, and it's going... That's like a 1.7... 1.66 liter, something like that, with 7 cups, whatever that transfers over to. And I made a yeast starter earlier in the week, a 1 liter yeast starter. Chilled and decanted it, and then made another yeast starter last night, which is that one, the 1.66. It stepped it up to the number of yeast cells I needed for this lager. So, very important. And maybe at some point, I've got Camtasia Studio, you know, where I can do the screen capture, and I kind of go through the steps if I decide to do that. I may do that and just kind of go through using Mr. Malty and yeastcalc.com, since some people may not be familiar with it. So just something I can throw out there. But about 6 minutes left in the first 30 minutes of the 90-minute boil, and then I got to throw in some 60-minute hops. So I thought I'd go ahead and throw this part out there about more beer mail. Dang, man, I've been absolutely hooked up the last couple of months, and I very much appreciate it. To all the people that's giving me beer mail, Yambar 44, Puka NC, John, J.O. Malone, John, and now MBG, Main Brew Guy has hooked me up. Got the package in Friday at work, and very excited about opening. I'm not going to open it on camera because I'll end up dropping something. I've about had a couple of mishaps doing that before, so I'm going to get her opened up and set out, and then I'll talk about what you got. I've been watching some YouTube videos here in between things on Brew Day, and I noticed, John, you got your package from Main Brew Guy, so that's cool. But yeah, as far as the beer's going, I missed my pre-boil volumes for like a quarter of a gallon. I don't know where I missed that at, but I was looking for like a 7.75 pre-boil, got 7.5. So I went and changed my numbers on Beersmith, and that changed my final volumes. So my pre-boil gravity went up to 1.041, and I got 1.042. So right on time. Let's get this open and see what we got. If you caught that or not, I don't know what it was. Isn't that beautiful? Homebrews and beer mail. Loving it. Gary put us a little letter in here, same evidently that went to John. So talks about his evil twin. He added 1 ounce of Centennial at 40 minutes instead of us doing like the going by the recipe that was online, Mr. Malty, I guess, with a 2010 and flame out. And doesn't look like you, can't remember if you whirlpooled. Seemed like we kind of went back and forth about that. You did dry hop. I don't think John dry hopped with his, if I remember right. And you used USO5, and I can't remember what I used. I don't think it was USO5. But anyway, man, I am absolutely, totally excited about these evil twins. And I've seen you mentioned on John's video that it's still young and might need 2 weeks in the bottle. And I do not think I can wait 2 weeks. Maybe on one of them, since you were so gracious to give me two. So I really appreciate that. And I'm pretty sure all of these are bottle conditioned because it looked like there was a little sediment on the side of all of them. So I've got them unboxed, obviously. And we'll get them in the fridge upright. The other one is the rye. Black Rye PA, Black Betty, and Gary sent the recipes for all his beers that he sent me, which is also really cool, and a late Amarillo Pale Ale, which I'm also excited to try because I love Amarillo hops. Late Amarillo Two Row Pilsner, Crystal 40, Munich, Flake Barley, Aromatic, and all Amarillo from 30 minutes 15 and 1 minute. Yummo. All right, I appreciate it, Gary, man. I'm definitely gonna get you back. Right now I've got the one beer I have on tap that I wouldn't send you is the one I sent Hockey Player, and a couple others have tried, and I haven't got my score sheets back on it yet. I did send it to a competition. That was the late hopped Amarillo and Simcoe, and the nose just doesn't follow the taste doesn't follow the nose at all. So it's not, I don't know, it kind of grows on you. It's one of those beers you try it and you're like, I don't know about this, and then after you drink a few they're like, okay, I can see this, but it definitely needs to be more balanced. I've mentioned this before in videos, but I really don't want to send you that one. And the other two that I have on tap right now is the cider, which I may send you. I don't know if you like ciders. I sent them to a couple. A lot of people love that cider. If you don't like it, you can give it to your wife or whoever to try. Some people don't like ciders, but I actually like it myself pretty well, and I've talked about that before. So, and the other thing I have on tap is that Arrogant Bastard attempt that's not even close. I may send you one of those. I don't know. It's I'm kind of going back and forth. I really don't have anything good to send you right now. I just kegged, and an all Falconer's flight, well, not all Falconer's flight, the Falconer's flight with the Magnum or Warrior, whatever it was they used for bittering. Kegged it yesterday, so I would really like to wait until that's done and just go ahead and send you that and maybe the cider and probably this other Arrogant clone that was a fail, just to see what you think about it. And I mean, it's okay beer, it's just, it's nothing great. But yeah, I do appreciate it, and this is probably going to do it for this video. There's, I don't want to show no more. I mean, I just got some more hop additions and the same old routine, so I'll let you know how it goes later on. And getting these bad boys chilled down, don't know which one I'm going to try first, but I guess I do need to wait till the sediment falls out. Don't really have to, but I probably will. All right, man, appreciate you. Appreciate you coming by the channel, and holla. Thought I would add this to the end of the first part of this video, where I was talking about the brew day, the lager. But anyway, I was really surprised at this lager yeast, and some of you can chime in on this. Like I say, I've not ever brewed a lager, but I dug the multi-step or the two-step yeast starter, and today's Tuesday and brew day was Saturday. I think I got done with everything about 2 o'clock, maybe Saturday, somewhere around in there. And the starter had, the second part of the starter, the 1.6 or 7 liters, whatever it was had been sitting on the stir plate since Friday night. So probably 9, 10, 11, 12, 1, 2, probably from 9 o'clock till about 2, somewhere around there. So you're looking at like 17 hours. Is that right? 17, 18 hours. So it was definitely a high carousing, or should have been. And pitched it. We went and done some other things. We went out to eat, I think, came back. And 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, like 5 hours later, I walked down here and I was doing something. I heard bubbling. I was like, no way that thing is working already. But yeah, man, it was just a little bubble every once in a while, and there was just a little bit of carousing on the corner of the better bottle that I'm using. And I'm using a better bottle. I don't normally use buckets, but yeah, man, that yeast took off. I did my yeast starter at 60 degrees and I pitched at 60 degrees, and then I dropped the chest freezer down to 50 degrees, and that's what I'm going to ferment at for probably 2 weeks or until I see the carousing stop, drop out, which is why I'm using the clear bottle, so I can keep an eye on this thing, because I am going to do a diacetyl rest when it gets within 1 or 2 points of the final gravity. And then I will bump it up to like 60 degrees for, I forgot what I looked at in my notes, I've already got it written down, like 24 to 48 hours, I can't remember. And then I'll drop it down to the lagering temps. I may, depending on if I need to brew again and use this chest freezer as a fermentation chamber, I may go from 50 down to 40 for a couple of weeks and then drop it on in the beer fridge there and let it lager in there for however long I decide to let it lager. But yeah, I was just going to show you this. Saturday it started, Sunday night it was blown up and it was already moving right along, and you can see it working. Maybe you can, I don't know if you can see the yeasties doing a little thing in there. But yeah, I was very pleased with how quick that lager yeast took off. So I'm pleased with that, and like I say, I'll keep an eye on it and watch for the carousing to start falling back down. And when it does, I'll take a gravity sample and see what we got and go from there. But yeah, I may, like I say, I probably will just go ahead and do a video maybe on the yeast calculators that I use for those of you that aren't familiar with them or don't use them or whatever. Probably boring to some of you, but it's very important to pitch the proper amount of healthy yeast. And burp. I don't know if I'll add, if I do decide to do it, I'll see how long this video goes, maybe add it, or maybe just do it on its own. That's probably the best thing to do. But